What's up, YouTube? It's Kenny J from Kenny J TV, back at it again with another day in the live video. Right now, I'm headed to the gym. I wish this was a normal thing for me, but it's not. I don't usually go to the gym early in the morning. I either try to go around lunchtime or in the evening, but my next 2-3 days are super packed, so I'm going to try to go in the morning. I'm going to go in the morning. I got up about 6 a.m. this morning and started cleaning up and handling some stuff. So we gotta get this great workout in before we start work today. I do have to start work right at like 8 or 8:30 because I just have so much to do. A lot of clients to follow up with, policies to write, X, Y, and Z, and also training my assistant. I know you guys saw in the last video, I finally hired an assistant. Let's go. He's truly been a huge help to my company. I'm very appreciative of everything that he's doing, and you'll see more of him in the video. Most likely we have some training and some other things to do today. I got a lot of questions of how did you go about hiring your assistant, when is it time, and honestly I wish I would have hired my assistant a year ago, to be honest. But I kept putting it off, saying I'm gonna do it later, and kept saying I need to hire an assistant, and I finally did it. And the free time I have now is great. Like, granted, I still have a lot of work to do, but you know, if I do need to step away for XYZ, I know that the phones will be answered and my clients will be taken care of. Yes, I'm at McDonald's. I feel like McDonald's gets so much hate, but their breakfast is A1. Argue with your mom, not me. I always get the McGriddle and the orange juice. Every time. I'm going through my email, checking voicemails from last night, as well as catching up on a few text messages as well I got from a few clients. So right now I'm gonna go through my email before I do anything, and then I'm gonna reach out to my assistant. He just instant messaged me and said that he was here, and then we can do a little bit of training. What I've been doing also is going through my tasks for each day and assigning certain things to my assistant. So of course, for so long I've been doing it all myself, but then I'll be like, okay, so this is something that he can do, and then we'll get on the phone and we'll role play and go through each scenario that can happen when he reaches out to the client or does like the admin work. So right now I'm going through my tasks. I don't have that many for today, surprisingly, so I'm just going to assign a few to him and then give him a call and do our daily training. My morning's going well. I started a little early, had to go to the gym like 3 hours ago, so I've been up for a little bit now. Awesome. Trying to get some work done. I have like some meetings today I have to go to, like an event, so I'm trying to get everything done kind of early. So in the HubSpot, like I always say, you want to make sure that that's the first thing you pull up in the morning, that and your email as well. But we'll visit your email in a little bit. We're gonna go through these tasks that I've assigned to you, and then I'm just gonna have you do them while I do some back-end work, all right? Just got off of a 40-minute call with my assistant, going over everything that we needed for him to complete the task and following up with a lot of clients. That does free up so much time for me. I went to having a million things to do to only having, oh, this is not my task, hold on. 5 things to do, honestly, and it's like writing policies for clients. So what I have to do now, I have this trucking company that reached out to me. My first carrier was unable to do it, so I had to go to a backup carrier, and they were more than happy to do it, which is really great for me. And so it's a pretty long application. I do dread doing those longer applications, so I'm gonna go ahead and call her to get it done and then get this submitted so we can go ahead and get everything handled, because I know she really does need this policy ASAP. So I'm gonna give her a call, and then I do need to go to the post office to send off a check for one of my clients as well. At the post office right now, I have to mail off a check to one of my clients. Basically, he had some premium. Something happened with the carrier where they had to send him back money, but they send it to, of course, the agency account. So I have to mail that out to him. Mailed it out once, was unable to send the carrier because he wasn't there, XYZ. So I'm going to send it out again. So I'm going to call to let him know when it's gonna be there so he can be on the lookout. On the way to the bank now, before I left the house, I checked my mailbox and I saw that I had a letter from one of my carriers. Not a letter, it was a check. So it's really cool how I get commission from them. Of course, that's deposited in my account. And then we get a bonus monthly depending on the amount of policies you ride and a few other factors as well. So every, I think it's third Friday of the month, I receive a check in the mail. So then I have to manually deposit that in my account. I've asked them like, hey, are you guys able to deposit it? They said, no, it has to be a paper check, unfortunately. So that's like a thing I do once a month is go to the bank and deposit the check. Also, so I was checking my phone and my assistant messaged me. And it's so funny how people are. So this client reached out to me, or this prospect reached out to me months ago, and she wanted to do her hair salon and wanted to insure a few other things. So then she said, you know what, I'm gonna hold off on the salon, but I want to get auto insurance and renter's insurance through you. And I said, cool. Literally had him follow up today with the client, and she said, stop, I don't want the insurance. Why do you guys keep reaching out to me? And I'm like, you know, because you requested me to reach out to you. You know, I'm not gonna blindly reach out to anybody. You know, I don't buy leads, I don't use leads. Anybody that I reach out to has reached out to me. So that's always the fun part of insurance is, you know, dealing with people like that, but we just keep it pushing and don't let, you know, any type of negative transaction affect our day. He was very professional about it. He sent me a screenshot. Because the biggest thing for me is communication between me and him. So he sent me a screenshot and said, is this okay if I say this? I'm like, yes, it's perfect. And yeah, so on to the next, you know, I'll follow up with her in like a year. Because one thing I don't believe in is like deleting contacts. I'll follow up in a year to try to win her business, but I'll do it myself. Just because it's kind of like a sensitive contact. You know, she was already like, stop bothering me. So I know that I'm able to talk to her and I'll be able to, you know, calm her down and things like that. Can I deposit that in the account ending in not loading while that's being deposited? I don't know what I'm going to eat for lunch today. I have a networking event tonight where I'm going to, and they usually have vendors there. So I think I'm going to support one of them tonight. They have like Caribbean food and some other cool things. So I think I'm going to do that for dinner. I might run to the store or something and get something quick to make or get something out. But I have to go home first. I'm starving, but I'm gonna like get a snack because I really need to handle a few things. I have to, what do I have to do? I have to provide a proof of residency for one of my clients so their policy doesn't cancel.
Thank you for your business this morning. And if we don't see you again, we hope you have a great holiday.
I appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Let me tell you how my assistant is the GOAT. So, he you know, apologized to the young lady, the client that reached out to me that I was just telling y'all about. And he sent me a screenshot and she was like, oh my God, I thought this was a spam. He said, that's totally fine. And then she said, let me check my schedule and I'm gonna get back with you. So he turned that complete no into a, oh, well, let's talk about it. Like, let's definitely talk and get this deal closed. So shout out to him for that. So on the way home, I posted my reel for the day on Instagram. Forgot to do it at 11. I usually have reminders, but today hasn't been too crazy. It really just slipped my mind. What I'm gonna do now is one of my good friends is moving into a new apartment, so I'm doing his renter's insurance. I will be completely honest with y'all. I don't do renter's insurance anymore, to be honest. I'll do it for like a friend or someone that reaches out and is like, hey, can he, like, you the homie from college, you know, can you do renter's insurance? Usually I won't do it, one, because the amount of time it takes for the amount of money I get is not worth it. Of course, when I first started, any and every policy that I got, I was like, yeah, I'm gonna do it no matter what. But now it just makes more sense for me not to do it. I'll do other types of homeowners policies like primary home, a seasonal home, short-term rental, dwelling policies. Any of those I'll do. It's just renter's insurance is not really worth it. And my friend, I told him, you know, if you want me to do it, I'm more than happy to. You know, I don't mind. So I'm gonna go ahead and get on that now. If you hear the loud lawnmowers in the back, sorry for that. But just finished up the meeting with my assistant. We went over renewals as well as endorsements on policies. It's nice to, you know, lighten the load on me and put a little more on him. He's learning very fast, and I'm just so grateful, as I'm gonna keep saying in all my videos, I'm so grateful to have someone that is able to help and also very reliable. So I'm stepping out to lunch now. I'm gonna grab some food, and then I have a haircut appointment at 3:15, I think. So I need to go ahead and eat and then get ready for that. And the best part is I can go on Do Not Disturb. Also, I got a new phone system. So now when you call, oh, let me show you. I got a new phone system. I invested in one. If you've ever like had a call with me, you know, for the first year and 5 months, I had a phone system. It was a really good phone system, but I didn't pay anything for it. You know, I'm always trying to find a good deal, but this phone system is amazing. We can do video calls, instant messaging. I can share my screen with him. I can pull his calls, like they're all recorded. So this is what you hear now when you call my agency.
Thank you for calling Remedy Insurance and Wealth Builders, LLC. This call is being recorded. If you do not wish to be recorded, please disconnect at this time. Please hold for the next available agent.
But that's so, like, to me, because before it would just ring like a normal phone. So for me, that truly means a lot, because it's like, I don't know, it made me feel like my business elevated. And now I feel like, I mean, I've always been like a real business, but now I feel like a huge corporation, you know. And then I have him answering the phone, so no calls come directly to me unless that person has my direct line, and I don't like to give that out, or if they have my extension, because I'd rather it go through him so he's able to learn how to maneuver and do certain things, and when he runs into certain issues, figuring them out. And then it gives me time to do work, and I have free time to work on the business and not in the business. On the way to a networking event now, I have to pick up my friend. Well, I'm here now waiting on her to come outside. It's been a long day. It's been a long day since I last talked to you all. I'm going to the networking event. Fun fact, the networking event we're going to, the last one I went to at the same place, I now insure that building. So the owner of the building I networked with at the event, and now she's my client. So it's really cool to go back there and see her and network further. I've gotten a few clients from the events as well. So, wow, she looks beautiful as always, guys. Like, I'm gonna put the camera in. Like, she, hey, Crystal Hall, the truth, man. Look, she know. Go ahead. She knows she the truth, man. Look, man, listen, man. Networking event.
Yay!
Let's get it. Fresh cut. Who this? All right, I'm able to record a little bit now. It's a speed networking event. We got some people down here.
It's a birthday shoot, photo shoot.
Well. Say hey to you too. So, I met a lot of great people today. Great networking event. They got some good food here. Definitely gonna support the businesses. And love to like put my money for my business into, or love to put my money into small businesses that are trying to grow. So this is a great, great networking event. Of course, we'll get Crystal's feedback after after we meet this. So I'll check back in with you guys. Right here. That's all you gotta do. It's it. So, Crystal, how did you like the event?
I loved it. I had so much fun. Met so many new people. Made some connections. I loved it.
Networking is key.
10 out of 10 recommend.
10 out of 10 recommend. Here. And this food about to go.
Bananas.
Just arrived to a business lunch with a mortgage lender that I work with, as well as a realtor. We're going to go ahead, have lunch, chop it up. Chop it up, catch up, all the good things. And so I'm excited about it. I haven't had a business lunch in a while. I'm just checking my messages from my assistant to see what's going on with that. So I'm gonna vlog a little bit of the lunch. They're really heavy in content as well, so it's nice to go to a lunch with them, bounce ideas off of each other and so forth. So I will let you guys know when I'm inside. I had to park a little distance away. It's right outside of Charlotte in Belmont, North Carolina. Never been to this restaurant, but they definitely recommended it like 5 times. So I'm like, all right, we can go here. So let's see what this food hitting on. So I've never been to downtown Belmont, but this is a really like nice and low-key area. And then look at the restaurant as well. It's the one right ahead, Nelly's. This is a really dope downtown. It gives me like vintage vibes. So, I don't know, I might be back here. Do a little walking around. I know they have a university here, but I might come here to walk around and stuff. It's a vibe for sure.
In the batter, is that a lot of
berries? Can I get chicken and gravy?
Chicken and gravy?
Does that come with any sides or anything?
Yeah, it comes with mashed potatoes and collards, but you can replace it if you like.
Can I do fried okra and collards?
Yeah.
No, actually. Can I get mashed potatoes and okra?
Yeah.
Hi y'all, we heading out.
We're out.
Maya the realtor, yes. Ebony the mortgage lender.
Absolutely.
Hey listen, if y'all here, you know how to tap in.
Yeah, y'all stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
Things are on the way.
Things are on the way.
Like, they're coming. They're in the midst right now.
Yes.
You heard it here first, folks. Y'all, I'm not gonna even lie. It's 8 o'clock at night or in the evening. I was running errands. I was like, oh, I didn't end the video. So let me get back real quick and do that for y'all. Thank you guys so much for tuning in to Kenny J TV. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe, and hit that bell for my latest notification. If you made it this far in the video, tell me your biggest goal for the second part of 2022. If you're watching this video and it's another year, tell me what your goal is for the rest of the year or for the new year. Would love to hear what you guys have going on. Again, my name is Kenny J, the insurance guru, and this is Kenny J TV.